Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist, and I preach Christianity and its continuation, Sikhism. If we have one God, there should be one faith. And if you have many faith, that means you have different gods. That is called interfaith. So the people of the interfaith, they are spiritually blind people. And the same as the cults in Christianity, they are over 400. And I attended their conference in London, and I told them that you are like blind men defining an elephant. We have one fold in Christ Jesus, which is Church of God, headed by one shepherd, Christ Jesus. And the good news was delivered to the shepherd in the field, who were illiterate, not educated like the university professors and theologian in the University of Jerusalem, where they were coining the moral laws, but they were corrupted. When Jesus went to ask for the fruit, they had nothing to give him. And that was his last parable of wine press. Old wine is the moral laws. And they were not producing good quality wine, good quality moral laws, as they were the Samaritans. They had good quality moral laws because they were faithful to Abraham and faithful to Yahweh. Whereas the Jews, they were saltless people, unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. And that is why when Jesus told in the temple that he is the Messiah, they took stone to kill him. And the same thing to the Samaritan woman, never mind the man, woman. When Jesus told her that he is the Messiah you are looking for, oh, she was so happy. And she went to the town, her village, and told everyone, I found him. So, the people of Samaritan are the Gentile. About them, Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. And Jesus then told them that when he was coming to Jerusalem, that prophets were sent to Israel, but they maltreated them, and like Elisha, who was sent to Israel, but they did not honor him. And there were many lepers in Israel. The leprosy is the result of greed. If in the previous life you have been greedy, you get the next birth, you get leprosy. And if a priest is greedy, then in the next birth he become a viper, a snake. That's why John the Baptist called the priest a brood of vipers. So here I'm going to do John 8, verse 21 to 30. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. They mean the same thing. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within his temple. This is the temple of God. not made by human hand, but by the Lord of the nature, most beautiful. In his temple of God, created by the demiurge potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, same thing, etc. And it is called Harmandir, or Emmanuel, God is with us, if you are not a greedy person. Like these three people in the churches, the doctor priest, to get rid of them, Jesus died on the cross. And they are the neo-rabbis. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, it fulfilled in them. And they made the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So these churches, they are worse than the synagogues at the time of Jesus. They were much better. And those priests over there, rabbis, they were hypocrites. And these people are super hypocrites. Everything is demonstrated. Paul never took any money out of the church. He gave to the church, not take anything out of the church. Because what applies to flesh, the opposite to spirit. In flesh, the priest will take, rabbi will take tithe. In spirit, we give them. Because we get it free. The rabbi had to go to school to study scripture. So, the situation today, these people, hireling dog hole priests in the churches, they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. And Judas Iscariot was thrown out at the Last Supper, because he was a thief, stealing money from the purse, which is the church purse, as the new rabbis do in the churches. So churches are synagogue of Satan. And Church of England, headed by Queen, is a typical example of the Church of Satan. And when her soldiers die, they say they glorify God. What type of God was that who was glorified by killing and looting people? Salvation Army people say they die for king and country. Humble. And our brother William Booth is not in St. Paul's Cathedral, but Viceroy of India, Viceroy of South Africa, General Army people who bring money. And they are said they glorified God. So, Salvation Army people, they exercise love called agape, unconditional divine love, whether you are black man or a white man, whether you are poor or whatever you are, destitute, and they serve them. And they are nearest to God, and these Church of England priests, they hate them. Church of England priests dream of sitting in the House of Lord, because their bishop can go there as the House of Lord, but not the other bishops. It's a discrimination, they are racist, spiritual racist. So let's carry on with our motive. So here I'm doing, according to St. John 8, verse 21 to 30. Jesus said to the Pharisees, I'm going away, and you will look for me, but you will die in your sin, which is transgression against the moral law, which are binding moral laws of Elijah. Elijah means by God is Yahweh. John the Baptist was prophet Elijah, and he was binding people in law. Here it is. So, here is John the Baptist holding scripture. And these people, Jewish people, in the temple, they were making them Jew outwardly and not of heart. And when you become Jew outwardly, then you break your covenant with Abraham. So John the Baptist was establishing their covenant with Abraham by baptizing them in the name of Abraham and Jesus in the name of his Heavenly Father Yahweh. So here it is, under Adam you have races, under after tribes and so and so. So that's why 144,000 that would be saved are all mentioned by tribes and not as Jews. So here come the scriptures of Jew, which is inwardly. This is outwardly and this is inwardly. Under God. God is spirit, which is invisible. So Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, Jew come here. So they are never born, never die. So not a single Sikh, Jew or Hindu or Muslim is ever born or dies. But the tribal people born, tribal people die. So you can see in India, you know, they are all separating on sectarian basis, that this man is a Hindu, this man is Sikh, and this is a Muslim. That is, they are becoming Hindu, Sikh, Muslim outwardly, which is super bastard fanatic devils. And they will fight and kill each other as they did in 1947 and 1984. You will see a lot of things happening. So this is a spiritual self, and this is the John the Baptist, a witness to the light and not of the light. This is angel and prophet here. Here are the saint, sons of the Most High, saint. John the Baptist was a prophet, that he was an angel. And not a saint. So people in the churches, they make him a saint. Saint John the Baptist. I went to the Mount Athos, is well known for this things. And they have a monastery in Essex. And which is named as Saint John the Baptist. I visited 3 times on Oxford, you know, interfaith meeting. Are friends of Mount Athos, and I pointed to them, hey, look, John the Baptist was not a saint, he was angel. They don't mind me, they still carry on. And these people, their ears are hardened, as Jesus told them in the temple. So they don't want to know you, they only know what their mount, abbot, tell them. And abbot is an adulterer. If you know Matthew 19, though in Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. So you can't bind anyone in Jesus. Anybody who bind them, like abbots and other things, they are antichrist. In Mount Athos, they don't allow the woman. In Jesus, here you are, the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his Heavenly Father Yahweh. And they were the one of Holy Spirit, and they were seeking this narrow gate, and where this killing with Jesus I bring in Moses, that burning bush. So the killing of his word you bake your faith and burn the ego, your tribal ego. And here, you, when you enter, you have to be a twice born, a plant and not a seed. Seed can't bear fruit. So far you are in your tribal ego, you can't enter this one. So that is to subdue that. The seed has to be turned into a plant. And that plant is to be grafted to the true vine, Christ Jesus, to suck the daily bread, living bread, and then digest it over your heart and with the teeth of logical reasoning. You need teeth. It's not a milk. Scripture is milk, but this is a gospel. It's by teeth, logical reasoning. And then you brew logo, that gets written over your own heart and not in the in ink on paper. So Bible has no gospel, but it is their letters, and letters are milk for the babies. So here they join, graft themselves, and this is called Celestial World of Sadhus. Here your soul is concerned and not your physical body. Here your physical body is concerned and not your soul. So here there's a neither male nor female, not Jew, not Gentile. All by soul is the son of the Most High. So we are all sons of the Most High, whether in flesh you are a male or a female, doesn't matter. So that's why among sadhus there is no tribal identity. And they will tell you, we became sadhu, we don't carry tribal identity. And over there in India they live naked, because the moral law do not apply here. Moral law apply here, down. Down here moral law, no moral law apply here. That's why they live in the wilderness. If you want to live in secular world, then you have to put on the clothing. So this is Celestial World of Sadhus, and sadhus are sons of the Most High, like father, like son. Lazarus, friend of Jesus. Friend means that he is the authority. He is the omnipotent ambassador of Christ Jesus. And when he died, and the rich man died, the rich man ended in hell. And when Lazarus died, he ended in the lap of the Abraham. So, eternal saint. And then, you know the story, the rich man said, go and tell my brother not to cheat anyone. And then Jesus said, they don't listen to Moses. And how can they listen to Lazarus? So Lazarus was a typical example of resurrection, which Jesus was telling here, that I'm going, you can't come there. That rich man could not go there. It was Lazarus who was a beggar. His wounds were being licked by dogs. He went there, but not the rich man. People who cheat, they can't go there. So, let's carry on. So, Jesus said to the Pharisee, I'm going away, and you will look for me, but you will die in your sin, which is transgression against the moral, binding moral laws of Elijah, Prophet Elijah, John the Baptist. And in works are karma. According to the rabbis and Brahmins, they lead people to good karma. And the His word you get it by the grace of our supernatural Father. No man can give you. Not even Christ Jesus could give you. Because Peter was first born. He could not understand gospel. When at Pentecost he received the very Spirit of God, he became the twin brother of Christ Jesus. Oh, then he was the first one to start looming and as if he drunk with the new wine and start preaching gospel. Before he was quiet man. So the works called karma, you get reincarnation and no salvation. These rabbis in the temple, they were leading people to works, and there were no source of salvation. So that's why salvation is by the word of his God. When you preach gospel, then you are sons of the Most High, and then you represent our supernatural Father, like Father, like Son. Where I am going to the Royal Kingdom of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., which is above the celestial world of Sadhus, like Melchizedek, you cannot come unless you are twice born of the Holy Spirit. By His grace, by the grace of our supernatural Father, or unless a female becomes a male, spiritual male, as Saul, you know, he was disciple of Gamaliel. The root of the word disciple is discipline. So he was learning the moral laws of Moses from Gamaliel to be disciplined and live in an atmosphere creating kingdom of heaven. Saul became and changed his name to Paul when Saul became independent. Remember Damascus experience. So Jesus had mercy on him. So he was very in his heart what he was doing. He was very conscious that it is wrong what he is doing. But he had to do the will of his master, Gamaliel. Otherwise, master will say, hey, this my student is no good. Throw him away. So he was doing it under obligation, not from the core of his heart. So that's why Jesus came into his life and set him free of the yoke of Gamaliel. And the blindness which the letters create is represented by the thickness of the scale that came off his eyes. So much more in my other videos. So St. Paul, you cannot enter the royal kingdom of God that has a low for humble and narrow for the solitary people. So the Jews said, he is not going to kill himself, is he? They took the literal sense, you know, he want to kill himself and then he will go where you cannot go. Because he said, where I'm going, you cannot come. He said to them, you belong to what is below. You belong to what is below, the secular world of works. In works you eat this food here. On the Sabbath you go to listen to the word of Elohim, our supernatural Father that is here. And Elohim is free of mammon, no touch of mammon. That's why on Sabbath the Jewish people, they sit at home doing next to nothing. They can do philanthropic work as Jesus advised Simeon, the Pharisee, that invite those who cannot invite you back. or the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, and he did philanthropic work, and that is on the heart of the person. So, celestial world of the sadhus, where your soul is concerned and not the physical body, are neither male nor female, neither Jew nor Gentile, but the sons of the Most High Elohim. To this place, Jesus, his friend, the omnipotent ambassador, Lazarus, he sent him, you know, over there, and he then asked him to come down to show them, tell them what that pale place above is look like. And Lazarus described the home of Christ Jesus. So he described to them the home of our forefather, supernatural father. And when that reached the ear of the temple priest, they were very furious. They said, this man is making the dead man for 4 days dead. He's making them alive. If people come to know of his works, then nobody will come to us. Our synagogue will go down. And that is why Jesus came to pull it down, as stated in John 4, that you no more worship God over in that temple or on that mountain, but here in truth and in spirit. So you don't need to go to church to worship God. You worship God by performing works which should be on truth and in Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit means for the benefit of humanity. People get Holy Spirit, or people, sorry, can get Spirit from God by His grace. But they use that Spirit in putting that common sense in businesses and other places to make more money. And they forget about God who give them the sense to do that. So that's why Christianity is 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. And not for everyone. But I do not belong to this world. Describe the home of Christ Jesus. You belong to this world of the moral laws that binds and make you orphans, you know. You are not a free man, orphans. You are bound by law. But I do not belong to this world, but just a minute. I have to wait a little. My text has disappeared and it will come back soon. Not responding. So I put the text on my computer, you know, and I use a webcam, and webcam is recording my picture, and the text is in on that one. Something happened. Just come back, you know. You belong to what is below. The secular world of works I belong to what is above, the purely spiritual celestial world of the sadhus like Melchizedek, where your soul is concerned and not the physical body or neither male nor female, neither Jew nor Gentile, but the sons of the Most High Elohim, where you have to give your own account to God. Rabbi can't give your account then. Rabbi gave it count at Passover. To this place, Jesus, his friend, the omnipotent ambassador, Lazarus, and he described the home of Christ Jesus. You belong to this world of the moral laws that binds and make you orphans, because you depend upon the moral law. Or if your rabbi is dead, oh, you are lost, you know. Who will explain to us and all that? But we possess the Holy Spirit, and our covenant is with God, is of Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit is the key to the treasury of our supernatural Father. So we have the key to the treasury, and we spend his treasures by preaching gospel from our own heart and not from the dead book, Bible and other things. Moreover, do not bind you. You are free in Holy Spirit, which is common sense. As the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, and also Mary Magdalene was set free of the seven demons of the Menorah, seven candles of the Menorah, the rituals. And so are the lesbian and gay set free in Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus, if they go for him, they are free, because they are not bound by any law, by conscience, of the Holy Spirit. Their heart should be clean. That is why I told you that you will die in your own sins, sins created by the moral laws, getting reincarnation according to your karma, or KARMI AAWAE KAPRRA. That's what, you know, second coming of Jesus said in Japji Sahib, in meditation, KARMI AAWAE KAPRRA, that means through works you get this cloth which is a human cloth. NADRIN MOOKH DAWAAR, that if we have grace of our supernatural Father, then you find the gate to salvation. So, NADRIN MOOKH DAWAAR, salvation as demonstrated by Jesus in Lazarus, a saint. Or if you do not believe that I am the Anointed Son of Elohim, the Christ, you will die in your sins, because Jesus set you free of the Bible. So in the name of Jesus, if somebody is carrying Bible, he is Antichrist, because the gospel gets written over here. If somebody asks you a question, you should be able to answer from here, and not looking at the Bible what to say. Die in your sin, bearing the heavy yoke of your rabbi, the blind guide. So they said to him, "Who are you?" Jesus said to them, "What I told you from the beginning, when you were performing miracles and all that, Nicodemus, a clean-hearted person, he realized that unless he is from God, he can't do that one. But the other people did not like to admit it, because otherwise there will be no business. As today you have the doctor priest in the churches, and I have written this article about these 12 laborers, and I'm sending it to all the churches, and you will see how they will react. They are not interested in this one, you know. They are not interested in this one. This one is on my website. If you go there, you will find this one. You can write to me, I will send you. Jesus said to them, what I told you from the beginning, that clean-hearted, once-born Nicodemus believed. So when Nicodemus saw he is performing all these miracles, then he came at night, frightened of the other, shouting at him. And then he told Jesus, unless you are from God, you can't perform these things, you know. Then Jesus then advised him that once-born people cannot understand it. So I have much to say about you, the hypocrite. The hypocrites in condemnation. But the one who sent me is true. Our supernatural father is true. That's why he was, whatever coming from his mouth was to glorify our supernatural father. Not against his will. In his will. And what I heard from him, I'll tell the world. What I heard from, I tell the world. They did not realize that he was speaking to them of the supernatural father, Elohim, represented by the middle candle of the menorah. So, Jesus said to them, when you lift up the Son of Man, then you will realize that I am the Christ, and I do nothing on my own, but I say only what the Father taught me. Taught me or what pleases my Father, not what pleases the public, as the psychic politician will do. Moses put on Christ, and he perceived the face of God. Those people who have Christ in their heart, they only can know God. Saint Thomas went to India. Over there, people called him Christ Thomas. And his laborers over there, they were not called Christian, but they used to be called Christ. Sikh and Christ mean the same thing. But the Portuguese Pope went there, only one Christ, Jesus, nobody else Christ. So he put them to death and he burnt their books and other things. Moses put on Christ and he perceived. You can't see the face of God, you perceive the face of God. But he showed the back to the people, while Jesus came to show us the very face of God, very face of God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Through his word, the Oral Torah, in fullness, is not lacking nothing, you know. the top root of the tree of life. Matthew 13 verse 52. So here it is. This is the top root. It lacks nothing. And here the tree, without top root, is dead. So that's why they are orphan. Orphan here, without this one. Whereas the Samaritan rabbis, they had the knowledge of this Oral Torah, and their disciples, they were not orphans. They were introduced this Oral Torah. That's what the Samaritan woman possessed. And in that Oral Torah knowledge, she wetted Jesus in Holy Spirit. The one who sent me is with me, living in his temple. Not temple, not made by human hands, but by the greatest artist, demiurge, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, the lords of the nature. He has not left me alone. He has not left me alone, mean that he has not left me as an orphan, because I always do what is pleasing to him. So remember that Jacob had 12 sons, and only one was faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, Joseph. But the other 11 crook patriots, they wanted to kill him, but they sold him as a slave. And as soon as he left the promised land, there were none who was faithful to Abraham or to Yahweh. So Abraham is the father of the faithful. So he kept them out of the promised land, and Yahweh stopped rain, and the land became barren. So they had to go for Egypt for grain. And that is the story, you know. Left me alone because I always do what is pleasing to him. So if you turn your face to God and turn your back to public, then you are always with God. People have called me heretic, and people have called thrown me out of the seminar in Oxford University because of my this t-shirt slogan, which is light on living lampstand. So their people don't like me over there, but they don't kick me on my cheek, you know. They don't slap me, because he spoke this way. Many came to believe in him. So he told them in plain language, you know. So many came and believe in him. And our Father God blesses you and everyone in agape, unconditional divine love. That is, without love, we are nothing. So our Father God blesses everyone in agape.